1954, the Arizona desert outside of Tucson. Near sunset, James E. McDonald, a senior physicist at the University of Arizona, is driving through the expansive desert with four meteorologists. Off in the distance, McDonald notices a strange point of light hovering above the mountains. The bright anomalous object appears to be made of aluminum. He points it out to his colleagues, but none of the men are able to identify it. It disappears without much of a reaction. Little do these men know, but this mysterious sighting has just changed the course of UFO history.
James McDonald became fascinated with the controversy over UFO studies. And the more his fascination grew, the more he realized that these cases had to be investigated.
Over the next 16 years, McDonald interviews over 500 witnesses, uncovers important government documents, and gives presentations of UFO evidence to huge crowds across the country.
He was the first man to take hard science into the UFO phenomenon and bring it into the scientific community.
Today, McDonald's legacy lives on in the archives of the University of Arizona, an untapped resource of UFO investigation and evidence.
There's a massive amount of material here. The collection is extensive, very meticulously detailed handwritten notes. We've got film, video, physical artifacts. There could be some pretty interesting information here.
With special access to his archived files, UFO Hunters aims to piece together the investigations of James McDonald by bringing classic case files into the 21st century. UFO Hunters meet with archivist Scott Cossel, who escorts them into the vault.
All right, so here we are now. This is the archive of the University of Arizona Special Collections. The James McDonald papers run from here all the way down that way. This is a restricted area. Happy hunting.
Wow.
Bill Burns will reopen one of the most controversial cases in UFO history, the 1965 Heflin photographs, and put them through vigorous tests and visual analysis.
These four images have become the holy grail of ufology. If they're real, they're the best pictures of a UFO we have anywhere.